Hey guys, in this video we're going to look at the Overloud TH3 guitar amp simulator plugin that's included with Cakewalk by BandLab. We'll cover how to use it and some examples of the sounds we can get out of this plugin. This tutorial will be very focused on how to use this guitar amp plugin, so if you're not familiar with Cakewalk, we recommend also checking out our tutorial series on that as well. Let's start by opening a new project. The first thing we need to do is enable the Overloud plugin, since it doesn't always enable by default in Cakewalk. Go to the Utilities menu at the top and select Cakewalk Plugin Manager. Switch the plugin category to VST3 Audio Effects. At the bottom, check the box that says Show Excluded. Select TH3 and press Enable Plugin. If you don't see TH3 here, it's probably already enabled and we can skip this step. Next, we need to add an audio track that will process the guitar amp simulation. Right-click on the blank track area and select Insert Audio Track. Drag the bottom to expand it. Set the input to the input your guitar is on, and in my case it's input 1. Arm the track for recording and press the input monitoring button to hear the guitar track. All we need to do now for setup is add the plugin to the track. Press the plus button for the effects section and add TH3 under Audio Effects and Guitar. With the setup done, we can get into how to use the plugin itself. The left side has banks of presets, and we can select a bank at the top, then select a preset to use as our sound. Let's select a preset and start with how to use the plugin. If we click the presets button at the top of the middle section, we can hide and show the presets. The middle of the top is for zoom of the signal chain, and the right is for the components, which allows us to add individual parts of the signal chain. To add a new component to the signal chain, drag and drop it into the part of the signal chain where you want it. To remove a section, right-click on it and remove it, or replace it with something else. If we zoom in on our signal chain, we can easily adjust the individual controls. It's designed to be very intuitive. You can turn parts on and off by clicking on the power buttons for amps or clicking and pressing down on the pedal. From there, all the knobs are click and drag to change their settings. For the microphones, we can double-click on them to change the microphone and click and drag them around to change the microphone position. The bottom left gives us a way to split our audio signal, which we can use to do things like apply different effects like delays to the left and right pan sections, and then we can control how they're mixed back together after. The bottom right is a tool to allow us to navigate through the signal chain really quickly. On the top left, we have our level meter. If we click that, it has a guide to help us to adjust the level on the audio interface to get the guitar where it needs to be. Next are a few of the master controls for stereo, sensitivity, gating, EQ, reverb, and delay. Live mode just makes it quicker to make changes without prompts. The middle has a tuner that we can activate by clicking on the tuner button, and we can also mute the guitar here. The BPM can be adjusted by double-clicking, tap tempo, or locking it to the host. Last, we have the volume output for the plugin, since we want a good level, but we don't want it to be clipping. There is a looping tool, but this can be difficult to use when you're working alone, so I prefer to use something with a foot controller or just build a loop in Cakewalk. The top menu gives us a few settings for activating the demo version of Overloud TH3, which is what comes with Cakewalk. We also get MIDI controls for our effects and pedals, automation, the manual, and some info about the plugin. Now let's go over what we get included in this plugin. The Overloud TH3 plugin that's found in Cakewalk is actually a demo version, but it's still pretty good. It is functional, but there are limited amps and effects compared to the full version. We get access to 15 amplifier heads, 12 cabinets, and 15 effects pedals or rack units, all of which have adjustable controls. We also have 3 microphones that can be used with the cabinet. Thank you. Thanks for checking out this video on using the Overloud TH3 guitar amp simulation plugin in Cakewalk by BandLab. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check out our social media links in the video description to keep up to date on all our new content.